Hi guys, my name is Moji. Welcome to Miami Muscle. I'm going to be sharing with you my 20 years of bodybuilding experience. I will also be showing you my tricks and tips that made me a natural pro bodybuilder, the common mistakes that most guys do when they're in the gym, and I will also be showing you the proper form. It's about the tempo, the safety, and also the amount of weight you're using to be able to maximize your training effort. What I see most guys do in the gym, they first of all go in there thinking about lifting weights. They put too much weight on the load and they don't really feel the muscle they're training. But my style is to basically allow the muscle to move the weight first and not the other way around. Bodybuilding is not about weight training. It's about muscle first. My goal is to build as much balanced muscle as possible so I can be able to show my body off aesthetically without just thinking about lifting weights. It's about getting the mind and the body connected to your workout. When you're training your shoulders, your mind should be in your shoulders. So really connecting your mind to the muscle helps you focus 100% on the feedback that you're getting from that muscle. So if you don't get any feedback when you're exercising, then you're just going through the motion. So your workout is basically pointless. There's nothing behind it. And that's another common mistake that I see is guys lift too fast, too quick because they said, oh, I just want to get it over with. But if you want to maximize your result, the goal is to concentrate and work on your tempo. When I say tempo, I'm talking about the speed that you're going down and the speed that you're coming up on the concentric movement. With me, my tempo is basically 4 seconds going down, and I go 3 seconds going up. The reason why I use these numbers is to help me keep my tempos in line so I don't get out of my tempos. When my muscles get fatigued or when I get tired, the weight gets a little too heavy, I drop the weight down and I still make sure I maintain my tempo. So using the proper amount of weight by really using the load to actually slow down gravity, which we call resistance training, that allows the muscle to react a lot more than if you allow your arm to just drop back and forth. So there's no connection when you're going straight up and down real fast. You are not gonna connect to the muscle. But when you really slow it down and control the tempo, the muscle is gonna realize, okay, why are my arms not going down as fast? Oh, there's a load here, so I need to react. So when I'm training my biceps, what I'm feeling for is the contraction. That's number one. The contraction of the muscle coming up and down. I wanna feel a burning feeling, not a sharp pain feeling, not a tired feeling. It's a fatigue burning feeling at the top of the movement. So let's say I'm curling 20 pounds. I start from the bottom. By the time I come up and down, I'm moving the 20 pounds away from my body. The further you move away from your center of gravity, the heavier the load. So this means you don't need to lift as heavy a weight as possible. All you need to do is pick up a reasonable amount of weight so you can be able to use the muscle to control the movement and not just moving the weight from point A to point B. Your body will let you know how heavy you need to lift because you're not always 100%. Certain days you're 50%, certain days you're 80%, and certain days you're 100%. And if you're struggling, you know, to get that connection in, you'll end up hurting yourself, you know, and that will set you back for days or months to come. So if a guy tells you you should bench press 400 pounds to build bigger muscles, they are actually setting you down to get injured in the long run. So allow your body to detect the load. Don't determine the load before you get into the gym. So this is what I do when I train, is to feel for that contraction. You wanna really feel the burn. After about 2 to 3 sets, you start feeling the pump, what we bodybuilders call the pump. So you feel the muscle a little bit more swollen, a little bit more bigger than when you first started. The reason why you're having the pump is because once you start lifting and you know, doing your bicep curl, the heart rate goes up. And that way your body releases what we call nitric oxide to dilate the blood vessels. When the blood vessels get dilated, then we have more blood flow into that particular muscle that you're training, and this is what creates the pump. So the muscle is getting broken down when you're training. You know, there's two amino acids in the muscle called actin and myosin. So in order for you to build muscle, You have to be able to break these amino acids down. So if you don't break them down by really feeling the pump, the muscle is not gonna grow. You're not gonna be able to build new muscle. And this is what I always tell guys about, really thinking about loading the muscle throughout the movement and making sure they're keeping their form without getting out of the form mode, so you can really feel the pump so the muscle can get enough nutrient from the blood flow so you can be able to build new muscle. So heavier weight or heavier lifting doesn't translate to bigger muscle. So the goal here is to use a reasonable amount of weight. That's all it is. And the muscle doesn't know what 40 or 50 or 60 pounds is. So once the muscle feels the load, there's a reaction going on right away. So the main goal here is not to sacrifice form for repetitions. If you're gonna get to 15 and you get to 12 and you're losing your form, drop the weight down, go down in weight, and make sure you finish that set properly instead of just going through the sets by using improper form to get to the numbers. Training and eating the right way all the time has a lot of health benefits. You know, you feel better, your immune systems are up, you don't get sick as often, emotional and mentally balanced with the people around you. Because sometimes when most guys go on a crash diet to look good or to lean down, they end up getting a temporary result. And when they go back to their normal so-called diet, they end up gaining the fat or gaining the weight that they don't want to gain. So this lifestyle is consistency. The more consistent you are, the better you feel, and the more your body wants what you do, because food and exercise is like information to our body. The more we eat right, the more our body wants to eat right. The more we train and exercise, the more our body wants to feel this way. So all we have to do is put the right information in our body to get the right results. So right now I'm gonna talk to you about the power of the mind. Why it's very important for you to stay on course and to stay motivated and to stay strong no matter what. And one thing I wanna ask you is, what is the reason? Why are you doing what you're doing right now? Why didn't you do this 2 years ago, 6 months ago, 3 months ago? Why now? So what I'm gonna advise you is to find a connection, attach a reason to this process. When you attach a reason to this process, you will feel the motivation all the time. For example, my reason to do this as a little kid is to basically be the best as I can, because I grew up from a country that we didn't really have anything. We didn't have gyms. We didn't even know what nutrition is all about. I just wanted to build muscle. So finding that reason in my mind, every time I go into the gym to train, I always look back at how I started. That is my motivation. That's what kept me going. So every time I, you know, feel like I don't want to go to the gym, I always remind myself, remember where you came from. Remember your reason. So always find that emotional attachment to this process, because some days are going to be tougher than other days. That emotional attachment is what's going to keep you motivated. So you guys think about, you have only one body. You cannot trade that body for another. So give yourself a chance to live a healthy lifestyle by giving back to your body. So it's like taking your car to the shop. When you see that check engine light comes on, the more you train, the more you eat right, the more you exercise, the bigger the engine in the car. And the bigger the engine, the more high octane fuel you put in your body. So this is what your mindset should be every single day. And when you exercise, when you work out, when you eat right, it's a lifestyle. So don't leave that lifestyle in the gym. Take it with you. You know, your daily life, your job, your relationship, your family, your friends. You want to be the best you can around these people. You know, when you're going through your daily life, certain days are tougher than other days. You don't give up. You keep pushing. You keep going. So your training, your nutrition, and your fitness life is like this. Keep it going. No matter what, no matter how weak you think you are, no matter how tired you think you are, these reasons that you have in your mind will always prepare you to keep moving forward. As we're about to move into the exercise portion, I want you to keep these things in mind. Proper form, safety, mind and body connection, and stay motivated. And at the same time, it's about not punishing the body. It's about training the muscle and allow the muscle to get you where you want to go. And this is why teaching you all these little details is going to help you maximize your training. So keep this in mind and make sure you connect all these things when you start working out.